The album basically discusses like every kind of relationship you can have, whether you're with someone or your friends, or relationship you have with your parents, and then also if you lose a friend. So it's just a circle of life and everyone you meet on a day-to-day basis, if you're in love with them, if you want to be with them, or you fall out of love. So it's just a full circle of life and love and relationships. Was it something that I did? 'Cause I gotta know what made me unbeautiful. Here I go, I'm going. I'm going. I wrote with Max Martin over in Sweden, one of the last songs we wrote together for the album. It's about a couple of different things. First of all, it's like about leaving my hometown and leaving a relationship and different situations and trying to come over here to the States and make it, you know, in the industry. But it's also been about, you know, getting away from certain groups of people. And it's called I'm Gone, I'm Going, because I was gone, I switched off a long time ago. So I was mentally gone first and then I physically went going. So that's what the song is about. Hey, yeah, take a look around, I'm beside you. I'm right here for you now. Here For You Now was actually the first song I worked on with Max a long time ago for the album, and it's about being there for a friend when they're really stuck in a mess and getting themselves into so much trouble, and just letting them know that you're there for them and you're going to help them out, but there's only so much you can do. So that's what Here For You Now is about. 'Cause when it comes to you, there's nothing I can do. I can't break you down. Goodbye, I also worked on it with Max, and on this one with Dr. Luke and Katy Perry. Actually, I wrote this song with. It's about being in a relationship and you know what's coming, you know what's going to be next, and they're going to break up with you. So Slow Goodbye is about not wanting to go round and round in that process again. Unbeautiful, I wrote with Max Martin and Rami over in Stockholm. We produced it there as well. And Unbeautiful is again about being in a relationship and trying to figure out why it's ending and what you did, why you went wrong, what did you say, and asking yourself like one of the hardest questions, and why don't you find me attractive anymore? When was the point that you switched off? When did you find me unbeautiful? So the whole song is based around that concept. Psycho Bitch, I also wrote with Max Martin and Slaven Kocheka, produced over in Stockholm as well, and it's the funny, punky, very young girl rock song on the album, and it's not me, it's just a character that I've created. It's the only song that's not like 100% I've experienced on the album, and it's about getting revenge on a guy and trying to get back at them. When I Look At You is about going out to a club and seeing someone that you like and basically wanting to go over and talk with them, dance with them, have a drink or whatever. So it's a kind of fun song, and I worked on it with Greg Wells and Cara DeGuardi in LA, and it's the only song I got to work on with those two. So that's why it has a kind of fun, different influence than the rest of the Max Martin songs. I don't know. Thinking Out Loud is my favourite song on the album, and I've worked so hard on those lyrics, and it's 100% me. It's about being so confused and lost with different voices in your head and just trying to figure out what kind of group of people you fit in with, even if you do fit in with any group, and just not knowing yourself. And Thinking Out Loud is just about venting all the different voices and all the nonsense that's in your head. Dead But Breathing was another really tough, intense song to write. I worked on it with Max and Per and Camilla over in Sweden, and it's a very simple ballad about being numb in a relationship, and that's basically what the whole song is about, and not knowing what to do or how to get around it and feeling just so lost. Misfit is the only song I didn't write on the album. Desmond Child Andreas Carlson and Evan Tabafold worked on this song. But I heard it a few years ago as a demo when I was working in Sweden, just in Andreas's car. So I loved the lyrics and I thought that they would fit into kind of what I've been writing about on the album. So I asked them if I could do it and they let me cover it. So it was a nice cover to put on the album. Make It Back I wrote with Dave Hodges and Mitch Allen in LA, and I had spent a long time in LA and I was getting pretty homesick. It's kind of been about just trying to get back to one person and missing them, and that's all the song is about really. I'd be crushed if you walked away. I'd ruin it beyond repair if you weren't there. I'd be crushed. I wrote with Iman and Lily Robbins in LA. They worked on a lot of the newer Backstreet Boys stuff and stuff like that, so I wanted to get in with them to bring that pop influence onto the album. Crushed is actually one of the only kind of happy songs. Although it sounds sad, it's one of the more content lyrics where I'm actually happy in a relationship, and if the person leaves, I will kind of miss. Well, actually, it is kind of sad now that I think about it. So I guess if the person actually goes, I would be crushed. So it's kind of a happy, sad song. Love is a mystery. The truth of it hard to see. Oh yeah. Come to Your Senses it's the only song on the album that I produced in Dublin. I worked on it with Rory O'Connor, who was one of the first writers I ever worked with when I was very young, living at home. It's about trying to get the other person to come back, like bring them back into the relationship and just come to their senses and see what we had. Come Back was the first song I wrote for the album just after I got signed to Jive when I was 19, and basically it's the darkest song on the album. I wrote it with Dave Hodges as well, in LA. It's about the loss of somebody at home who died the day I actually signed my record deal. So I kind of felt, well, I guess because it just happened and I just signed the deal and I was in the studio, that was the first thing I could possibly write about. So I knew he was so close to the family and everybody in Balbriggan at home that I guess I tried to put myself in his family's shoes and all his friends around him and just write a song for him, dedicated to him, and start off the album on a kind of selfless path about somebody else. I don't want to want you, I wrote with Martin Hansen and McCain Nord in Stockholm in the very early stages of the album. And it's about seeing someone you're really into and you know you're never going to have them, and you wish you didn't have that feeling. So it's that unrequited love. I think when people hear the album, hear the lyrics and I guess the emotion behind the vocals, I hope I can touch people and like they can relate to what I've gone through or what I've seen people go through. So I guess it's just for people to feel connected to me and know that someone else may be experiencing the things that they're going through at that time.